Hi guys, I am here with Bennett, the toy poodle. He is going to get a shorter, tighter body. His legs are going to get flared out a little bit. A short, round face, short, rounded ears, a shorter top knot with natural curl in it, and just an overall cute little teddy bear look. So let's get busy. Wild man. I'm going to do some pre-bath clipper work with a four blade on the trunk of the body. Going to do a four blade against the grain on the chin. I'm actually going to trim his top knot and ears before the bath so that I can go ahead and scissor them now and let them air dry curly. Stuff is so silly. He's such a poodle. So the ears I'm going to bring to the end of the nose and I'm going to trim them off there. So I'm going to hold the tip of the ear under the jaw, round this up. We're going to blend this into the top knot. Same on the other side. I know you can't spin, can you? He says, yeah, but I can turn the other way still. I could fix that, but I don't want to. I'm going to taper the back of the ears. Good boy. Right in front of the ear here, I want to round this up with a little definition between the ears and the top knot, but not much. Little dogs like this, it's good to have a 7-inch pair of scissors. It's just the right size. So his top knot looks a little poofy right now, but my end goal will actually be shorter. The curl will make it look shorter. So I'm not too worried about that at this point in time. next, I'm going to trim the pads of the feet with a 40 blade. And I'm gonna do the tummy with the 10 blade.
Yeah. That's what we're gonna do. Come in. Up, up. Good puppy.
Time for a bath.
Yeah, let's go. Good boy.
Baby.
Yeah, don't you, Ginger Boy, baby?
Yeah.
Make sure Zan loves you. She does. She loves that puppy.
Yeah. Good boy. Now we're going to wrap him up in a nice warm towel. Disinfect the tub. Give that 10 minutes in the tub, the disinfectant, to have time to become effective, and head off to the drying table. Before I put on his head wrap, I'm going to comb out his head and ears because I want those to dry curly. As I'm blow drying him, I'm going to blow dry his mustache up and back to create a really cute look on him. Good boy. I'm gonna go back over the trunk of his body with a four blade. Coming against the grain at the underside. I took off the entire chest area. Again, taking the chin all the way up. Now that it's all clipped, I'm going to brush it one more time. And go back over it. Get it nice and smooth. His mom does not like a poofy pom-pom tail. She likes a straighter tail. We had a client come in yesterday with a dog in this haircut who wanted a poofy tail and not a straight tail. So if you have a preference, it's important to tell your groomer your preference, because we have so many different clients with so many different preferences that it's not a one-size-fits-all. The hair around the feet. Get all these clippings off. Good boy. And round the feet. His mom wants his legs fuller this time, so I don't need to take a whole lot off on the legs. gets so excited when he comes in that it actually takes him a few minutes to calm down and get into the groove of the haircut. Because he's so worked up. He's so excited. He loves to come get pretty.
Don't you?
All right, wild man. Let's go. Let's get you done. I know you got all excited again. I used a 5/8 HT on the inside of the ears to bring them into more of a teddy bear look.
get a cute little rounded face. Soften the front of this mustache with some curved chunkers.
All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell and stay tuned for our member recognition video. We'll see you next time, guys. Bye.